Hi, my name is Jihoon Jung. This is the last lecture of Deep Learning on Healthcare. Actually, the original plan for this lecture series was the previous lecture was the last, but I added another one since I found quite interesting argument in Twitter between influential people such as Hugh Harvey, Jeremy Howard, and Luke Ogden Lehner. So I decided to introduce this argument and discuss about the regulation for deep learning in healthcare medicine. Okay, do we need regulation for deep learning? Absolutely, in healthcare medicine. But there are some trade-offs. The start was the news from auntmini.com that ASIR, American College of Radiology, will offer free AI platform to radiologists at their own facilities using their own data to meet their own clinical needs. It seems to have no problem at first sight, but Dr. Hugh Harvey responded with cautious questions. His question list is quite reasonable. What about regulation of these homegrown AI systems? Are they to be FDA approved, cleared? If not, who is accountable? What about frameworks for risk mitigation, product support, adverse event reporting, legal liability? All of these questions are really important. Then, do radiology, one of the most active mobile radiology product creator, responded like this. If I use a tool to aid in diagnosing a lesion, is the FDA responsible? If I use a software tool, say a homegrown method program to calculate volume, is the FDA responsible? If I use a software tool, say an AI tool, for aiding in diagnosing, and the AI tool doesn't work, is the FDA suddenly responsible because it is AI? These are also quite reasonable, isn't it? Dr. Hugh Harvey responded, that's where I think you are wrong. FDA specifies that anything that is a medical device should be regulated. Book or MATLAB are not medical devices, but diagnostic radiology software is. Now, this argument is getting more interesting. Dr. Luke Ogden Lehner, one of the pioneers in deep learning technology development in radiology, supported to radiologist's opinion. He said, FDA is concerned with marketed devices, not devices in general. Open source and homegrown software is widely used. In the same way, I can use a ballpoint pen to perform tracheostomy. I can bear the risk of being unregulated software. Dr. Hugh Harvey replied, risks to patients are the same whether a device is marketed or not. Both industrial and homegrown are used on patients, and it is the risk to them regulators should be concerned about. Then Jeremy Howard, co-founder of Analytic and the Fested AI, responded, when I spoke to US lawyers that specialize in this field a couple of years ago, they said that doctors can choose to treat patients as they consider appropriate. This often included jerry-rigging solutions on the fly from things that are not approved medical devices. Response from Hugh Harvey is, that's off-label use of approved medical devices, used on an individual level. Very different from building an AI tool intended to be used on wide populations. There are many more tweets we can think about, but I'll end up with these tweets. So what do you think? Which opinion is right? For me, both opinions are correct. We should think about balance between innovation and regulation. This article was recommended by Dr. Hugh Harvey, and I think everybody interested in regulation for deep learning in medicine should read this article. If you can, you can use deep learning technologies to decide your patient case, and you develop the same some tools It will not be regulated. It's just your choice. But if you develop some AI radiology solutions and publish it to the public, whether it is open source or commercial product, it can affect some doctors to make risky decisions without any knowledge about the software. It is dangerous. So even though it is open source project, it should be with very strong warnings for the research purpose use. It's not just open source software. It can lead to make people or doctors wrong decisions. FDA defined this kind of software in a category called SAMD, software as medical device. There are several category class. Class one is just informing something not critical. Class two is including informing critical things or treat, diagnose, not that serious decisions. Class 3 is for serious diagnosis and treatment, and class 4 is for critical treatment and diagnosis. Here are definitions of critical, serious, and non-serious. Critical means life-threatening, incurable, and fragile. Serious means moderated in progression, often curable, not fragile. Non-serious means minor illness can be managed effectively and predictable. This is compatible with traditional medical device regulations, but there are some differences in SAMD device from traditional medical devices, especially in AI and machine learning based SAMD. Their algorithms and weights in neural networks can be updated with more data and improved very fast. In this case, it is quite different from medical devices. We need more process-like regulations. So recently, FDA announced a new modification white paper for AI and machine learning-based SAMD. The most important modification is FDA now considers adaptive learning. This is the key slide for new workflow. They now think AI, machine learning-based SAMD with SPS. SPS is SAMD pre-specification, and ACP. ACP is Algorithm Change Protocol. Most important update is if the algorithm and update is in the range of approved SPS and ACP, then simple documentation for this update will be fine without new approval process. Actually, AI and deep learning are very new and different types of healthcare intervention from traditional drugs and medical devices, so that regulation framework should be updated accordingly, considering many aspects, just like tweets we talked about in this lecture. And we need to have active discussions and submit better opinions to move on to good regulation framework. That will be the balance between innovation and regulation. Okay, this is final slide of this lecture and this lecture series. This is the quote by Dr. James Hedlow, author of article I mentioned earlier. We have to be realistic about regulation, but we cannot simply shrug our shoulders as an industry and say it's too hard, too expensive. We need to apply the same innovative thinking. We need to apply the same innovative thinking that we see from amazing technology companies developing technological solutions to how we can get this right. Crowdfunding for clinical trials or collaborative approaches to trials for similar devices across different tech organizations, the possibilities are endless. Thank you very much for listening this lecture series, and whenever I found good themes to share with you guys, I will get back to you with interesting topics. Okay, bye bye.